During the last 12 years, working and researching together with the peasant communities in the Mediterranean countries, there were many situations I was witnessing I didn't quite understand. Thanks to the concept of accumulation by dispossession, things became much clearer. Asunción Molinos Gordo. The exhibition I'm presenting here in Delfina Foundation is called Accumulation by Dispossession and is part of the fourth edition of the Politics of Food that this year is curated by Danny Burrows. When Danny came up with the invitation to do a show, we were thinking about how we could bridge the exhibition to my previous stay here at Delfina. Back in 2014, I was developing this research that had to do with trade and food insecurity, looking if there was any relationship between the way we trade with food and the lack of access to food, or regular access to food. The title of the show is Accumulation by Dispossession. That is a concept developed by the geographer David Harvey. It's a concept that I learned about earlier in my research, and that it opened up the possibility of exploring the relationships between farmers and fruit production from a completely different perspective. So the way the exhibition is articulated, in the first room you see more about the different facts that have to do with the dispossession, and then on the second phase have to do more with the accumulation. So the facts that you encounter in the first room have to do with the dispossession of land, the dispossession of power, the dispossession of dignity, the dispossession of seeds, and then on the second phase you see it in the accumulation of capital, the accumulation of foods, the accumulation of strategies and infrastructure. So the first work that you encounter is called Who Are the Hungry? The ceramic chart is made out of different ceramics. I made it with Monica Del Pino in Talavera de la Reina, that is one of the national awards on ceramic making in Spain. And this represents like the first fact that I encountered in my research at Delfina. I was wondering who are the ones who are food insecure, and I learned that are the farmers themselves. When I did it, I looked into different histories of ceramic making in like the farming communities. So some of them is done inspired in like medieval plates that were representing hunting and gathering scenes. Others are made out of pure concrete. The landless farmers are being represented by a form of terracotta. The mathematical model is a sculpture that I did in collaboration with Tamara Benari. It's a scientist from the INRA Institute in France. The sculpture that we have is a mathematical model based on the information that Tamara shared with me about the food production globally, minus the amount of that food that is being used not to feed people but to feed animals, to produce biofuel, or to produce a PLA, that is a biodegradable plastic, like the sculpture. The sculpture is being produced in PLA. The importance of these mathematical models have to do with how they are being utilized in policy making. They have a high level of distortion. They are highly vulnerable because of the complexity. It can only be understood by the scientists who made them, but not necessarily by the political body that is going to implement the results of these models in their policies. The sculpture dumping, it comes to represent just like a typical cargo of food aid. So dumping is a situation that is created when a country that has a surplus of certain crop moves into another country through an open market policy and starts selling that crop below the production costs. The local farmers that are in that country cannot compete, they cannot sell under the same price. So the next year, they think twice before growing that particular crop. So after 2 or 3 years of, you know, like perpetuating this dumping strategy, you will completely have the whole market to yourself because no local farmers will be producing that particular crop. So the word concealment consists of a cargo that is painted with the dazzle camouflage. The dazzle camouflage is a form of camouflage that was used during the First and Second World War. The sea is an ever-changing landscape, you cannot become invisible. But you can confuse your enemy and you can have this kind of camouflage that it makes you difficult to read. People will not be able to read how many boats are there, what is the direction, what is the phase, what is the speed, and what is the exact location. So nowadays there is another form of concealment that happens with cargo boats. They go out there, buy the entire harvest of corn, for instance, of Texas. They get it into international waters and they create an absence. They create an absence in the market, they wait until the prices hit the rock, and then they go to port and sell. All of the works in the exhibition are crafted. They're being produced by different craftsmen and women from different regions between Spain and Egypt. And I wanted to have this like crafted element in the exhibition in a way to highlight the manipulation and, you know, the man-made element in all of the facts and all of the data that I am sharing. Just to point out that the situation that we have today is man-made. It's produced, it's artificially created, and there's nothing natural about poverty. Poverty is not a natural thing.